Good morning, student. I'm Dr. Dharmendra Bien. Today we will discuss about Fermat numbers, that is especially in terms of a Pepin's theorem. It's a very, very important theorem. This is my seventh session in the first unit. Okay. So, just we have to glance about the previous class, that is what is Fermat number. The definition of Fermat number, a Fermat number is an integer of the form, that is 2 to the power of 2 to the power of n plus 1 for all n greater than or equal to 0. And also we can take in that, for example, n is equal to 0, n is equal to 1 and n is equal to 2. We can check whether it is a, what is the form of f0, f1, f2, like that. And note that the terms is f0 is equal to 3, f1 is equal to 5 and f2 is equal to 17. That means all the Fermat number, that is an odd numbers. We can observe the terms of f0 is equal to 3, f1 is equal to 5, f2 is equal to 17, f3 is equal to 257. Likewise, the terms is all are odd numbers, that therefore odd integers, and that and the divisors of fn, that is also odd. This is very, very important for the theorem. So, what we have to prove, that Pepin's theorem, it's very important. Fn is an odd number. If it is an odd number, definitely the divisor is also odd. So that is Fn and a prime factor of Fn, both are odd. Okay. Just we are to taking that the definitions of Fermat little theorem. We know that if A and P are relatively prime, can you guess what is that? Then A to the power of p minus 1 is congruent to 1 modulo p. Or suppose we have to choose the terms is, if p is not is equal to 3, that is a 3, p and 3 are relatively prime, then 3 to the power of p minus 1 is congruent to 1 modulo p. That is a Fermat little theorem. And what is that legendary symbol? If p is a odd prime and A and P are relatively prime, then that Legendre symbol A by P, that is equal to, that is equal to 1 if A is a quadratic residue modulo P. You can observe terms of if A is a quadratic residue modulo P, that is equal to minus 1 if A is a non-quadratic residue modulo P. Okay. Likewise, the terms is, that is x square is congruent to A modulo P, it has a solution. That means if that Legendre symbol is equal to 1, that is A by P is equal to 1, that is the terms of it is having a solution. That is, then A is called as a quadratic residue modulo P. And similarly, that Legendre symbol that is equal to minus 1, that means this x square is congruent to A modulo P, it has no solution. Then A is called as non-quadratic residue modulo P. And the next statement is a quadratic reciprocity theorem. If P and Q are odd primes, that is P is not is equal to Q, then, and also that P, or it can be written as P and Q are relatively prime, then the quadratic reciprocity theorem, that can be rewritten as that Legendre symbol P by Q into that Legendre symbol Q by P, that is equal to minus 1 to the power of P minus 1 by 2 into Q minus 1 by 2. And also next statement, that is a Euler criterion. If A and P are relatively prime, then A to the power of P minus 1 by 2, that is congruent to that Legendre symbol A by P modulo P. So, the terms is, if it is not having a solution, if A and P are relatively prime, so that is that value of Legendre value, that is equal to minus 1. So, we have to remember all those things. So, we have to prove that Pepin's theorem. So, now what is the statement of Pepin's theorem? Okay, just listen here. This is a very, very important question. The examination, they are asking that either the terms of 8 marks or 10 marks question, that theorem for n greater than or equal to 1, format number fn is equal to 2 to the power of n plus 1 is a prime. That is the first condition. It is a if and only if 3 to the power of fn minus 1 by 2 is congruent to minus 1 modulo fn. So, when I have to choose fn is equal to a prime number, then we can prove that 3 to the power of fn minus 1 by 2 is congruent to minus 1 modulo fn. Or, we have to consider this value and finally we have to show that fn is a prime. Okay. And the condition is for all n greater than or equal to 1. So, now I have to substitute that value if n is equal to 1. So, definitely that should be in terms of a prime. If and only if it must be satisfy this condition. You can check yourself. Okay, let us prove that by mathematically. Let us assume that 3 to the power of fn minus 1 by 2 is congruent to minus 1 modulo fn. You can call that is a equation 1. And next, we can substitute what is the value of fn here in equation 1. We need to substitute fn is equal to 2 to the power of n plus 1. So, here in the numerator, we can observe the terms that is 2 to the power of n plus 1 minus 1. So, that get cancelled, the term is, you can observe the term here. And also that in the denominator the term is 2 is there, it will go to numerator, that is the term is 2 to the power of n minus 1 is congruent to minus 1 modulo fn. That is equal to equation 2. You can remember these two equations are very, very important. The terms is when I have to substitute fn, that is equal to 2 to the power of n plus 1, that is equal to 2 to the power of n minus 1 is congruent to minus 1 modulo fn. Now, we have to observe that power, that is fn minus 1 by 2, that is equal to 2 to the, when I have to substitute that value of format number, that is 2 to the power of n plus 1 minus 1 divided by 2, or that is 2 to the power of n divided by 2, that can be written as, it will goes to numerator, that base is same. We should add that power, that is 2 to the power of n minus 1. Now, what we have to show that when I have to consider the 3 to the power of fn minus 1 by 2 is congruent to minus 1 modulo fn, we can prove that, or we can show that the terms is fn is a prime. You can remember the terms is fn is a prime. We know that p is an odd prime factor of fn. Then, what is the terms of p divides fn? If p divides fn means, that is p is less than or equal to fn. That is the equation 3. This is also very, very important. Finally, we have to prove fn is a prime number. That equation 3 is, that is p is less than or equal to fn. Just we have to remember, in the last we have to prove this one, that is fn is a prime. If p is a any odd prime factor of fn, that is p divides fn, which implies p is less than or equal to fn. We can call that is equation 3. So, now we are using equation 2, the term is that is 2 to the power of n minus 1, that is congruent to minus 1 modulo p, because the term is here p divides fn. You can observe the terms of here p divides fn. By using this concept in the equation 2, that is fn divides 2 to the power of n minus 1 plus 1. Okay, that means if p divides fn, fn divides 2 to the power of n minus 1, that means p is also divides 3 to the power of n minus 1 plus 1. So, by using that way, that can be written as the terms is, that is equation 4. This fn divides p divides fn, that is fn divides this term and p divides that one. So, therefore, this equation can be written like that. So, we have to raise the power 2 and squaring both side 2 on the equation 1. We get the term is, you can observe the term is, that is 3 to the power of f fn minus 1 by 2 whole square, that is congruent to minus 1 square mod fn. So, or it can be written as here, the 2 get cancelled, the when after taking the square, that is 3 to the power of fn minus 1 is congruent to, you know, the value of minus 1 square, that is equal to 1 mod fn. And we have to substitute that value of fn here. What is fn? That is 2 to the power of 2 to the power of n plus 1 and minus 1, plus 1 minus 1 get cancelled, that is 3 to the power of 2 to the power of 2 to the power of n is congruent to 1 modulo fn. That you can observe that term of power fn minus 1, that is 2 to the power of 2 to the power of n. So, therefore, we can take in the terms is 3 to the power of 2 to the power of 2 to the power of n is congruent to 1 modulo p, because p divides fn by using the same concept. So, we can call this one as equation 5. And also, when I have to observe that order of 3, okay. Suppose the order of 3 is equal to k, suppose k be the order of 3 modulo p, then it can be rewritten as this equation can be, if equation 5 can be rewritten as 3 to the power of k is congruent to 1 modulo p. By using the observation, the terms is definitely k divides, can when it equating these two equations, so definitely k divides 2 to the power of 2 to the power of n, which implies that is k is equal to 2 to the power of r. If that is the what we have to finally, we can show that if r is equal to 2 to the power of n. Suppose we have to take in it is a contrary statement. Suppose it is not possible, that is k is equal to 2 to the power of r for any r is less than r is equal to 2 to the power of n minus 1. So, the terms is, that is a previous term of 2 to the power of n is 2 to the power of n minus 1. So, for if this is the case, that is 3 to the power of 2 to the power of r is congruent to 1 modulo p, we have to substitute k is equal to 2 to the power of r in this equation. So, taking or we can squaring on both the side in this equation, or raise the power 2 on the both the side, we get that is 3 to the power of 2 to the power of r whole square is congruent to 1 square modulo p, or the terms is 3 to the power of 2 to the power of r into 2, that the terms is, that is congruent to 1 modulo 2, or so the base is same, you can add that power, that is 3 to the power of 2 to the power of r plus 1 is congruent to 1 modulo p. So, we have to taking the similarly, you can taking the squares or repeated square up to the term should be in the term, it will get in the term of 3 to the power of 2 to the power of 2 to the power of n minus 1 is congruent to 1 modulo p. So, we can take the power 2 until that power should be in term of 2 to the power of 2 to the power of n minus 1. We can taking that square. So, implying that equation 4, what is that equation 4? That equation 4 say that is 3 to the power of 2 to the power of 2 to the power of n minus 1 is congruent to minus 1 modulo p. Here, this one is plus 1 modulo p. So, when I have to compare that equation 4 and 6, that is it can be written as, that is 1 is congruent to minus 1 modulo p. That means, this is the only possible is p must be is equal to 2, because when I have to take this one on LHS side, that is 1 plus 1, that is 2 is congruent to 0 modulo p, means that is p divides 2. So, therefore, if p divides 2 means it is a contradiction, because p is equal to 2, that is only possible case is, because p is a prime number, if p divides 2 means that is that p is only odd divisor. We can observe the terms is, because fn is a odd number, if it is fn, the Fermat number is an odd number, if the divisor, the prime divisor is also odd. What is the term here? That is p is equal to 2. So, which is a contradiction to our assumption. What is our assumption? Our assumption is r is equal to 2 to the power of n, the terms of r is equal to 2 to the power of n. So, when I have to conclude the terms, if 3 comma p are relatively prime, then by Fermat number 3 to the power of p minus 1 is congruent to 1 modulo p. And we have to observe that equation 5 and 7 we get with the terms of, that is equation 5 is, that is 3 to the power of 2 to the power of n is congruent to 1 modulo p. So, the terms is, when I have to compare the two equation, the 5 and 7, so the terms can be rewritten as 2 to the power of n is less than or equal to p minus 1. So, when I have to add 1 on this, on both this side of this equation, it will get, that is 2 to the power of n plus 1 is less than or equal to p. But we know this one, this is the definition of the Fermat number, that is fn is less than or equal to p. Okay. When I have to taking that equation 3, that equation 3 is p divides fn, which implies the terms of p is less than or equal to fn, because p is the prime factor of fn. So, equation 3 says that, that is p is less than or equal to fn, here by using Fermat number fn is less than or equal to p. So, when I have to compare the two equation, that is equation 3 and 8, p is less than or equal to fn, here fn is less than or equal to p. So, only possible case is fn is equal to p. If fn is equal to p means fn is a prime number. So, this is the one part of the proof is over. Now, we can take in the converse of the proof. Let us consider fn is an odd prime. What we have to show that? We have to show that, that is 3 to the power of fn minus 1 by 2 is congruent to minus 1 modulo fn. Okay. Suppose we can choose fn, the term of n is greater than or equal to 1 is a prime, and the terms is 3 and fn are relatively prime. By using the quadratic reciprocity law, it can be written as the term of, by using Legendre symbol 3 by fn into that Legendre symbol fn by 3, that is equal to minus 1 to the power of fn minus 1 by 2 into 3 minus 1 by 2. If it is a 3 minus 1 by 2 means that is 1, because 2 by 2 that it is get 1. So, but when I have to observe this term fn minus 1 by 2, so definitely that must be a even term, because we know that when I have to substitute that value of fn is equal to 2 to the power of n plus 1, plus 1 and minus 1 get cancelled. This should be in the term of 2 to the power of n minus 1. When I have to choose if n is greater than or equal to 1, definitely this term becomes 1. It is because fn minus 1 by 2 is even. So, the term of, by using Legendre symbol, so we know the statement of Legendre, sorry, in terms of a quadratic reciprocity theorem. So, that is like this, and that which implies the terms of, if the Legendre symbol 3 by fn into that Legendre symbol fn by 3, that is equal to 1, which implies the terms of both are same. That is Legendre symbol 3 by fn is equal to that Legendre symbol fn by 3, since 3 and fn are relatively prime. And also, we know that 2 and 3 are relatively prime, or by using in terms of a congruence, it can be written as 2 is congruent, it is the term of, it is congruent to minus 1 modulo 3. So, here we have to raise the power 2 to the power of n on both this side. So, therefore, it can be written as 2 to the power of n. The term is 2 to the power of n is congruent to minus 1 modulo minus 1 to minus 1 to the power of 2 to the power of n modulo 3. So, when I have to add both side by 1, it can be written as, that is 2 to the power of n plus 1 is congruent to minus 1 to the power of 2 to the power of n plus 1 modulo 3. That means, so in the left hand side, when I observe the terms is, that is a format number statement, the definition, that is fn is congruent to 2 modulo 3. So that means here 2 and 3 are relatively prime, and fn and 3 is also relatively prime. So by using that Legendre symbol, that is 2, 3 by fn, at c is equal to that Legendre symbol fn by 3, that is c is equal to that congruence, that's equal, that is Legendre symbol 2 by 3, that's equal to minus 1. So finally, we know that the terms of 3 by that Legendre symbol 3 by fn is equal to minus 1. That means it's a non-quadratic residue modulo p. So by using Euler criterion, the terms of if 3 and fn are relatively prime, that can be written as, that is 3 to the power of fn minus 1 by 2 is congruent to that Legendre symbol 3 by fn modulo fn. That is, if a and p are relatively prime, then a to the power of p minus 1 by 2 is congruent to that Legendre symbol a by p at modulo p. But we know that in the last slide, that Legendre symbol 3 by fn, that's equal to minus 1. So therefore, 3 to the power of fn minus 1 by 2 is congruent to minus 1 modulo fn, since fn is a prime number. So the term is, if fn is a prime number, then the term of 3 to the power of fn minus 1 by 2 is congruent to minus 1 modulo fn. Hence the proof. This is, thank you.